This is me. I accidentally laminated my brows too much. My name is Selena Gomez. See, it doesn't even sound sexy.
Selena Gomez just appeared to confirm again that she has an issue with Hailey Bieber. So this video was unearthed of Hailey Bieber, where she appears to mock Taylor Swift.
A one-on-one rap battle full of the meanest lyrics about a celebrity since Taylor Swift's last album.
And as you can see, the video actually calls Hailey Bieber a mean girl and a bully. Selena then comments on that video saying, "So sorry, my best friend is and continues to be one of the best in the game." And of course, this is not the only alleged drama these two have had this week. Selena also posted this video in which she said she had accidentally laminated her eyebrows too much. Then Kylie Jenner posts this random out of context picture that says this was an accident above her eyebrows. Then she posts another random picture of both she and Hailey Bieber's eyebrows. So then this creator makes a video where she basically says that she believes that Kylie and Hailey were just mocking Selena's eyebrows, which results in Kylie Jenner coming on to defend herself. So are these two back in some sort of feud?
Is Kylie Jenner throwing shade at Selena Gomez? Selena posted this yesterday.
I accidentally laminated my brows too much.
And in Kylie's Instagram stories, she posted a photo of herself and said this was an accident, question mark. I don't really know what she's referring to. And then she posts this, looks like a FaceTime between her and Hailey Bieber where they're really focused on their eyebrows. Is this mean girl behavior, or is this just honestly, like, really bad timing? Or maybe someone's mad that Selena Gomez has taken back the Instagram throne. Selena's following count on Instagram has officially surpassed Kylie Jenner's. She is now the most followed person on Instagram.
Miley definitely knows something we don't. She was best friends with Alia Baldwin, Hailey's big sister. So she has known Hailey since she was 11. She and Justin are also good friends. Selena and Miley became friends back in the Disney days. She went to Selena's 30th birthday and became closer with her. Now Miley unfollowed the Biebers after becoming close with Selena.
Is it okay to be friends with an ex?
It's not a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, not necessarily.
Oh, someone else wrong apparently.
She didn't like it. I'm nervous.
Let's wrap this up before it gets any more awkward. Good night, everyone.
Finish getting ready with me while I tell you about my negative experience meeting Hailey Bieber. Before she was a Bieber. Also, at some point in this video, probably towards the end, I'm gonna put the picture me and Hailey took together so that way you guys have proof, because everyone is coming at me saying, proof, I got it. Before I get into it, I just wanna say that I'm not a Justin Bieber fan and I don't care who he's married to. I was more of a Hailey fan, but now that I've seen this energy again, I'm over her. And this will also be the last time I talk about it because my page is not a Hailey fan page, this is a makeup page, so I'm done talking about it after this. So I just want to set the scene for the story. I'm from Long Island, New York, and that is where the whole, like, Baldwin family is from. And I've seen Hailey multiple times, so I'm assuming she lived here at one point. There's a local outlet mall that has, like, outdoor shopping, and during, like, the holidays, they have tree lighting ceremonies with celebrities that perform as they light the tree. My friends and I were going to this concert, and I liked the celebrity who was performing, and I knew who Hailey was because she was friends with Kylie Jenner, and I knew she was friends with the celebrity, but obviously I didn't go looking for her at all. So I was crying because something had happened to me earlier in the day, and I was like nowhere near the concert. I was far away from it with my friend, and we were talking. So I was crying as we were talking, and walking towards us was Hailey Bieber and her friend, who I'm pretty sure was Madison Beer looking back, but that's not confirmed. So we're walking past each other, and I said to my friend, I'm like, oh my god, that's Hailey Baldwin. I'm gonna go say hi to her. So I went up to Hailey, and I was like, hi, Hailey, I'm a big fan. Can my friend and I get a picture with you? You could tell she was not happy. She was like, okay. So we get our picture, and I was like, I love you, Hailey. Thank you for the picture. I really appreciate it. And she was like, do you want anything else from me? And I was like, no. I got my picture. I appreciate it, Hailey. Like, I'm a big fan. Thank you. Love you. I appreciate it. Enjoy the concert. So she was like, okay, bye. So she walks away with her friend, and then they mock me, and they go, love you, Hailey. They said it so loud. It was like they wanted me to hear it. So I was like, okay, well, she's a bit of a mean person. Now, fast forward to the next year, I did see her at another concert, but I was like, I'm not going up to her. She does not deserve my satisfaction because that was just so unnecessary. So yeah, so after that, I don't really like Hailey Bieber. And I thought all this time, like, she's probably grown and she's different, but I feel like she's not after everything I'm seeing. So here's the picture. Okay, I look super cringy, but there it is. Yeah, so after that, I don't like her, and I think she's so mean. So this is the last time I'm going to talk about it. Follow me if you like makeup and skincare. I'll teach you how to get glass skin without road. But that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed.
Justin, can you stop running in circles? You're literally foaming at the mouth. Hey, Kylie. Hey, how are you? Wait, I have tea. So Selena just posted this super embarrassing thing. She like over-laminated her eyebrows. I know. Embarrassing. And I know that you hate her because she just surpassed you in Instagram followers again. So I was thinking, like, what if you posted an Instagram story, like a selfie over your eyebrows being like, is this what you're trying to achieve? Or like, was that an accident? And then take a screenshot of this FaceTime of us being like, because we have better brows than her. We literally have better eyebrows than her. Like, this is the shade of the century. The girls are gonna go crazy. Like, this is nuts. Justin, sweetie, mommy's busy. Go fetch. Hey, yeah, I'm alone. I was just starting my makeup. Okay, I'm done. What are we gonna do? How did everyone figure out we were making fun of Selena's eyebrows? Like, yeah, I wanted 2 million people to figure out we were shading her, not 200 million. Like, what do they expect from us? We're just teenagers. We're only 25. And yeah, I get it. Like, you're a mother of 2, and I'm a mother of a 30-year-old man. But that doesn't mean we can't gossip on the internet like the rest of them. Like, her eyebrows were objectively bad. Kylie, do something. It's your fault. Go comment something. They just don't know my heart. Yes, it's your fault. Justin, maybe if you didn't hump Drake's leg, we'd be invited to more things. Hi, Kylie. Sorry about earlier. Can you ask Kris Jenner if this is a good PR statement about the whole Selena Gomez drama? Okay. Hi. I am Hailey Bieber. You may know me for a few things, like starting the Clean Girl movement, Alec Baldwin, and also getting in fights with my husband's ex-girlfriend about her eyebrows. But I am more than that. I support all eyebrow shapes and sizes. Big, fat, skinny, poor. And I also am a girl's girl. So this year I vow to donate $25,000 on National Eyebrow Day to women in need of a makeover. I love Selena Gomez and Wizard of Waverly Place. Please tell me that's good. Cause I'm tired. Can you tell your mom to like drop some tea on Tristan and Chloe? Cause I've had enough of all this press. No, Justin, I didn't steal your phone again. That's it. No more Coco Melon for a week. Oh my gosh. Hi, Selena. It's Hailey. I stole Justin's phone. Yeah, your contact was under Papa John's for some reason. I don't know what that's about. But anyways, I just really wanted to say sorry. That your fans are so crazy. They're freaking nuts. They're so weird. You don't want to talk right now. What do you mean? I'm literally apologizing. Okay, fine, Selena, we get it. Yes, I went on Call Her Daddy when you were dropping your documentary, but I only alluded to you. I could have been talking about any of Justin's ex-girlfriends, like Kendall Jenner. Or Kylie Jenner. And also, yeah, we get it. You're the queen of music, and you won an Emmy, and you're on Barney. I don't even know what Barney is. I'm only 25, and you're 30. And I'm sure that you didn't start the glazed donut nail trend that sold out in every single New Jersey nail salon for the month of October. They ran out of sparkles. And I'm sure you can't do this. Oh, I'm sure you couldn't do that. You know what? This is war. I'm keeping an eye out for Selena. So say hello to Falsetto in 3, 2, swag. I'm mine to be. Hailey! Why are you crying, babe? I like that cry. No, for real. Why are you upset with me? Because I ran to Canada during this whole Selena Gomez drama? Listen, I was just trying to buzz with my boys, eh? Trying to slap puck with Usher. Okay, yeah, I get it. You're in all this drama with my ex-girlfriend. But I don't get in fights with your exes. I literally made a song with one of them. With Shane Montos. Sham Mendy. What's his name? Sean. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I get it. I made beautiful music about Selena, like boyfriend. But I made great music about you, too. I wrote Yummy about you. Because, girl, you got that yummy, 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 yummy. That was beautiful and from the heart, babe. Okay, you're pissed? Well, I made my bed earlier, so I want Cocomelon back.
Selena released Lose You to Love Me 2019, and this line became very popular. Hailey didn't just post this where it says, I'll kill you right after Selena's new song was released. She also posted this where she's basically throwing shade at Selena.
Like, who do you want to be when you leave this earth? You said you weren't going to be here much longer. Okay, then? How do you want your mom and sister to remember you?
So I would try really hard to be someone I couldn't.
Why are the girlies so bitter?
I'm not saying she deserved it, but I'm saying God's timing is always right.
Deserved what? Last I checked, Selena stays winning. And she didn't have to pay to do it either.
Yeah, on Drop the Mic, Hollywood's top stars face off in a one-on-one rap battle full of the meanest lyrics about a celebrity since Taylor Swift's last album. Yeah, on Drop the Mic, Hollywood's top stars face off in a one-on-one rap battle full of the meanest lyrics about a celebrity since Taylor Swift's last album.
It was funny to me, but she took it all serious and got in her feelings and got mad.
Girl, don't say I don't give you the latest tea. Okay, if you guys haven't been following, I've been giving you guys all the latest between Selena Gomez, Hailey Bieber, Kylie Jenner, Kendall Jenner, all the above, all the drama that's been going on. While Hailey Bieber and Kylie are losing hundreds of thousands of followers, Selena is gaining millions, all of this drama's going on. North and Gracie, Selena Gomez's sister, are baking a damn cake, bitch. North just posted this 2 minutes ago, and it's just them chilling, baking. You know what really, really gets to me is how many eggs they're spending, bitch. Girl, tell me why I went to the store the other day. I almost cried when I saw the eggs were a little bit on sale. But on the real, for real, I love seeing this because honestly, it has nothing to do with them. You know, North and Gracie are friends. They've posted videos before, but obviously the first thing that comes to mind is, damn, Kris Jenner, girl. Kris Jenner does not, she does not waste any time, bitch. She said, let there be peace. Boom, you know? But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments. Obviously, it has nothing to do with them, but I do wonder if they know something. Like, I wonder, like, I really do, and this is, like, true. I wonder how celebrities handle their children, you know? Like, I know that their comments are limited and stuff, but, I mean, I'm pretty sure they have access, you know? And I'm pretty sure videos pop up because of algorithms. So, I wonder how they deal with that, you know, because, like, you know, all the drama with her sister and her auntie and auntie's best friend, like, how do they handle that? Anyways, they did a part 2 in Gracie's TikTok, so go watch it. I mean, it's just cute. They're doing the Wednesday dance and they're cooking and they're baking and they're wasting so many damn eggs. But anyways, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to follow for the latest up-to-date tea, and I love you guys so much.
And I'm not saying she deserved it, but I'm saying God's timing is always right.
Selena is so much mature than me, because I would have went outside like this every day.
Kylie Jenner says she was not shading Selena Gomez and her eyebrows. Kylie commented, "This is reaching. No shade towards Selena ever, and I didn't see her eyebrow post. You guys are making something out of nothing. This is silly. I'm sorry, but why would they post this FaceTime of just their eyebrows? I've never seen them post something like this before, and I'm sorry. It's really not reaching. I don't think this is so silly, especially since the timing is also the time when Selena Gomez has dethroned Kylie Jenner as the most followed woman on Instagram. I would love to know Selena's thoughts."
"So we just got your results back, and I don't know how to tell you this, but you have been diagnosed with stage 7 jealousy. It's a disease, bitch. Get well soon."
I've been keeping up with the whole Hailey, Selena, Kylie, Kendall thing, and can I just say, my biggest thought when this broke is, there is way too much material out there on Hailey Bieber for her to jump on any social media platform and think she can make fun of anybody else. There is literally a video of her man leaving her on the floor while...
Side eye.
"This was an accident? Yeah, Kylie, probably the way Travis cheated on you when you were his girlfriend and the mother of his children was just an accident. Accidents happen."
"In the last 24 hours, I've learned everything that there is to know about Selena Gomez and Hailey Bieber. All of it was against my will. I don't know how I got here. I didn't know who Hailey Bieber was 4 days ago. When I heard her name, I thought that we were talking about Justin Bieber's sister. Does he even have a sister? Anyway, Team Selena."
Most underrated and funniest part of the Hailey Bieber Selena Gomez feud is who else besides the two of these women is still thinking about Justin Bieber in the year of our Lord 2023. I haven't thought of that man since 2015.
"Remember when Justin posted this after spending the holidays with Selena? Why did Hailey post a photo with the same caption 10 years later?
And I'm not saying she deserved it, but I'm saying God's timing is always right.
I realized that everybody else seemed to be narrating my life for me.
Yes.
So why don't I put something out that is my side of the story? It's not hateful or anything. It's simply a beautiful moment to let go of. And I'm really, really proud of it. I was able to tell my story about who I was from my own mouth instead of people from the outside being able to tell my story for me. Somebody asked me a while ago, what's the one thing you wish people knew about you? And I said I wanted it to be my heart.
What do you wish more people knew about you?
My heart.
You make me cry.
When this came out, I really felt like I always battled with the idea that people didn't really know me. They didn't know who I was. They didn't know Hailey for Hailey. And I just always had this constant battle where I was saying, I wish people just knew my heart. And I was the first CD and the first concert I ever purchased.
That is interesting.
Mm-hmm. It was Baby.
Wait,
One
she
more
was the
time.
First concert you went to?
In the first CD I ever had. She was the first record I ever bought, and she was the first concert I ever went to. Baby One More Time. Britney documentary yet, and I love Britney Spears. She was the first concert I ever went to. Like, I idolized her as a kid. And that was one of the moments where I was like, I don't have to be that 19-year-old body shape anymore because I'm not. Like, I'm also growing up. Like, that's the other thing, too, that I think I'm learning is I'm not 19 anymore. I'm 24 now. I feel like my...
Okay, so I see why a lot of people feel that she's copying Selena, okay? I get it. But I'm gonna tell you why I get it and why I understand and why I would assume that she would do stuff like this, because look, I don't care what anyone says, but Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez together is the definition of a teenage dream. And then we have of all these tweets. Pause to read them. Seriously though, she is beyond flawless and he's Bieber. They're a perfect relationship, forever alone. So it's pretty safe to say that she was a super fan before she was with the man, okay? Like, let's just be real. Like, you know, like, she was standing them until she got the man, okay?
So Selena Gomez has officially passed Kylie Jenner on followers on Instagram, dethroning the queen Kylie Jenner. And people are definitely reaching. Selena posted something about how she accidentally laminated her eyebrows too much and how she felt weird about it. And people are now saying that because Kylie posted this picture saying this was an accident, she's throwing shade to Selena, when in reality, she probably took the picture by accident and then posted it. And people are also saying she's throwing shade because she posted like a FaceTime screenshot with Hailey Bieber and like their eyebrows. Like, both pictures are only eyebrows, and I gotta say that was a little weird.
Do you guys think this is like mean girl behavior? They're doing something shady? Or do you guys just think this is just a coincidence?
My name, Selena Gomez.
I'm just sitting here minding my business, but there is one thing about this whole situation that doesn't make sense. And if we get an answer, it would actually resolve everything. Kylie told us that her post with her eyebrows and the accident reference had nothing to do with Selena, and that she apparently hadn't seen Selena's posts. Okay, cool. So apparently this situation, unrelated. And this situation, also unrelated to Selena Gomez. So Kylie, why don't you just tell us what your posts actually meant? With pictures of eyebrows and references to accidents, but apparently had nothing to do with Selena, so what was it?
What was the reason?
I accidentally laminated my brows too much.
I am doubling down for those who are doubting me. I do believe Kylie Jenner posted these Instagram stories about Selena Gomez. I think I just got the reason wrong. Somebody just sent me a video and I completely forgot Selena Gomez said this in her video yesterday, but let me show you.
I accidentally laminated my brows too much.
Why is it that 3 hours after Selena Gomez posted those videos on TikTok, would Kylie Jenner post this was an accident? And ironically, she put the text on her freaking eyebrows. And again, posted a screenshot of her and Hailey Bieber and them just showing their eyebrows. 1000% I am not reaching, in my opinion. They are shading Selena Gomez, and this is very, very, very childish. And what I wanna understand is why, because I personally gave Hailey Bieber the benefit of the doubt. I covered her Call Your Daddy interview. Like, I don't get it. And on top of that, they made up, like they took photos together. But then I saw that Hailey Bieber posted a video with Kendall Jenner, which was very shady. I did not cover it because I'm like, I don't want to read into it. She deleted it and said it was not towards anybody, but people think it was about Selena Gomez. And now her and Kylie are doing this. Like, I don't get it. Especially when they know Selena Gomez is somebody who constantly battles with her mental health. Like, what is the purpose? My God, this is so high school. Anyway, I don't do mean girl energy. This is not the vibe.
Oh, she took a screenshot of her page 30 minutes ago when I checked. But she had 50 million followers 30 minutes ago, and now she has 49.9, so she's in the 40s now.
People meeting Hailey Bieber for the first time.
Each other, and I said to my friend, I'm like, oh my god, that's Hailey Baldwin, I'm gonna go say hi to her. So I went up to Hailey and I was like, hi Hailey, I'm a big fan, can my friend and I get a picture with you? You could tell she was not happy. She was like, okay. So we get our picture and I was like, I love you Hailey, thank you for the picture, I really appreciate it. And she was like, do you want anything else from me? And I was like, no, I got my picture, I appreciate it Hailey, like, I'm a big fan, thank you, love you, I appreciate it, enjoy the concert. So she was like, okay, bye. So she walks away with her friend, and then they mock me, and they go, love you, Hailey. They said it so loud. It was like they wanted me to hear it. So I was like, okay, well, she's a bit of a mean person.
And when I tell you guys, the way Hailey Bieber looked at me, like mean girl energy. She gave me mean girl energy. And she looked at me like, sorry, but
I've met her a handful of times and every time she was not nice. I really want to like her, but I have to give her like a 3.5 out of 10.
And she was so cool to me.
she treated me like trash. It was just the vibe she gave off, like she really thought that she was better than everyone in the room. And I'm like, girl, we're both underage here, we're both signed to the same agency, like, treat me with respect. I'm coming up to you asking you how you're doing. And, you know, this, I don't really believe that celebrities owe anybody anything, but, you know, it's one of those moments where, you know, don't meet the people you look up to or who you idolize. Till this day, she's the least favorite celebrity encounter I've ever had.
It would be like, all eyes are on me. And this was back in 2015 when I lived in LA, and she wasn't even that famous yet. She was always just like, oh, I'm better than everyone here. Or that is at least the vibe she would get. Like, was always very intimidated by the people like Hailey, like the people that were just like, oh, I'm better than everybody else. Cause you're already in LA. You're already feeling insecure about your social status inherently, because that's just what LA is. And people that feed into that culture, I just think are not genuinely good people at the end of the day. So blessings to that girl. Don't know that girl. I hope that she gets the help that she needs. And I hope that she's like a nicer person after all of this, because regardless of your celebrity or not, I feel like everybody should be treated with respect, and you shouldn't think that you're better than anybody else regardless of who you think you are.
Ay, Dios mio, bestie, the believers are gonna be pissed. Listen, 2 hours ago, the LA Times confirmed that Justin Bieber's Justice World Tour has officially been canceled. So it says, after several postponements, the singer and his team have seemingly called off the remaining shows of the tour's European leg and more, including the June 2024 shows scheduled for the Kia Forum in Inglewood, the Atulta Arena, Sheffield in the UK, one of the upcoming stops on Bieber's tour, announced on Tuesday that the show has been canceled. It says, we regret to inform you that the Justin Bieber shows planned to take place at the O2 Arena have been canceled. We understand you will be disappointed and apologize for any inconvenience this may cause. Bitch, listen. Let me tell you something. We already know that, you know, he has had to have some time off due to his health, due to, you know, mental health and everything. And that is incredibly understandable because, honey, you got to take care of your mental, physical, and spiritual health before doing anything, all right? But, girl, this cannot come in a worse time. In the midst of Hailey Armageddon and Kylie Armageddon and Selena Queengeddon, we are, you know, experiencing that not only it is affecting Miss Kylie, Hailey, and the rest of the Kardashians, but it's also affecting Justin Bieber. And I'll tell you something, maybe he didn't cancel because of this drama, but girl, it is not good timing. Honey, listen, at some point in time, they're gonna have to do a background check on the people working for them, because damn, I feel like they're Selena fans. Anyways, bitch, whatever the case is, I hope he's good. I hope he's doing better. But I will tell you guys something, that I said this from the beginning. I had a That's So Raven moment, bitch. I had a vision and I knew that this drama will start affecting Justin Bieber. And you could already tell by the statistics of its Instagram. If you guys want me to get into it, make sure to let me know in the comments and we'll go into a little deep dive in our next video. So what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to hit that follow button. I would be so grateful. And I love you all so much.
If your For You page is filled with Hailey Baldwin, Selena Gomez drama, you just can't get enough. This is my hot take that I don't see anybody talking about. I just feel like there's a couple things that have bothered me about this situation for years, and now is the time to talk about it. So as like a longtime Jelena stan, this whole engagement was shocking. These caps, the very first thing, I was like, the man doth protest too much. Like, he does not love this woman. This is insane. And their engagement was exactly like 1 month after the Pete and Ariana Grande thing. So I was like, oh, he has the same manager and he's like doing a PR thing. But then it wasn't. But that is not the point of the thought that I have always had. And that is that I have dated toxic men and I've dated men that cheat. And the biggest common thread is that not only do they go for the insecure younger girl who's waiting in the wings once you call them out on their bullshit, but usually they talk shit about you so bad. And yes, Hailey very obviously was a fan of Selena's and is like trying to do everything she can to be attractive to her husband, who obviously doesn't like her very much. And honestly, that's where I do feel bad for Hailey Bieber, because that just sucks. Nobody wants to be second choice. And literally texts were leaked where she was like, I don't want to be second to Selena. And she's still second to Selena, like 4 or 5 years into their marriage. Okay, but I think that Justin is the mean girl. I think Justin is telling Hailey like things about Selena. I think he's being like, oh, I thought I was so in love, but I wasn't, or like whatever. I think when they got together, he was feeding her all these lies and stories about how he like never loved Selena and she was so toxic and she's so terrible. And like Hailey doesn't have to worry at all. He's only ever loved her. It's like this whole thing. And it made Hailey feel like she could be a mean girl to Selena because she was just like, oh yeah, like Justin thinks this, like everybody should know. But it's so not rooted in reality. Like, he's probably just giving her some sort of like false narrative, and it's Selena Gomez, so everybody can see right through it. And Hailey's still like, well, he said this is true and he's the only person that matters. And so she's just still living her mean girl life. And we've got the Jenners, who are obviously mean girls, surrounding her, and she's just like kind of fully formed into a whole mean girl now, where now I feel she might be like losing a grip on her marriage. Like, I have literally thought that they were going to get divorced this year since like 2 years ago. I've been like, it's winding down. And now she's probably just sort of like angry, jealous, insecure. It's coming out. She's not thinking. I get it. But at the end of the day, it's just making her look bad. She should really, I don't even know what she can do at this point. Yeah, I don't know if that made sense, but those have been my thoughts. Those have been my thoughts pretty much since day one. I'm team Selena, by the way.
Honey, this could be the most important question I've ever asked you.
Oh, well.
What's your take on the Selena Hailey situation?
Who?
The Selena Hailey situation.
Selena Gomez?
Yeah.
Who's Hailey?
Exactly.
We don't like her. Got it. Okay, got it.
Forget it. Never mind.
You mean the Hailey Bieber who posted slanderous videos on Selena Gomez? You mean the Hailey Bieber who collaborated with evil women to talk bad about our icon, Selena Gomez? hope you cleared your calendar today because we're going to Sephora. I think you know why.
Rare beauty!
Rare beauty!
I predict Hailey Bieber is going to get pregnant to try to hold on to Justin Bieber.
Yo. Yo, she on here getting cooked. But she got the senior citizens on this beef. Bro, they not letting her rest. That's
personally wouldn't buy anything from Rode.
He goes on to make some very good points about why he would never buy Rode, being that Hailey Bieber knows nothing about skincare. Her products don't even have SPF or retinoid, which he points out, which is true. But I wouldn't buy it for an entirely different reason. In 2013, two women friends started a company together. Started out as a clothing company, but they branched out into home goods, and they were eventually going to branch out into skincare and beauty as well. The company's name? Rode. Spelled the exact same way and trademarked since 2013. Pernod Ricard and Phoebe Vickers have built that company from the ground up to eventually be featured in Vogue and Elle magazine and sold in high-end stores like Bergdorf Goodman and Neiman Marcus. In 2018, they were contacted by Hailey Bieber, and she was trying to buy the rights to the name. They obviously said no, but clearly laws don't apply to Hailey because she went ahead and launched it anyway with the name Rode, and now they're suing the shit out of her.
I will forever be team Selena Gomez because a smoothie could never give us the moment that this song did. The bed's getting cold and you're not here. The future that we hold is so unclear. But I'm not alive until you call. And I'll bet the odds against it all. Say your advice cause I won't hear. You might be right but I don't care. There's a million reasons why I should give you up. But the heart wants what it wants.
This is me. I accidentally laminated my brows too much. My name is Selena Gomez. See, it doesn't even sound sexy.
Kylie Jenner is responding to rumors that her and Hailey Bieber threw shade at Selena Gomez.
Watch to the end to see Kylie's comment.
So you know how Selena posted this video saying she overdid her eyebrow lamination? Kylie posted to her story saying this was an accident and it's like right by her eyebrows. So people started posting videos saying this is shade to Selena Gomez because Selena had just passed Kylie as the most followed person on Instagram. I know. Like, what are we really talking about here? It's fun. Okay, that's not all. So this story was also posted with Hailey Bieber, like a close-up on her eyebrows. Kylie's close-up of her eyebrows. Everyone was like, oh my God, they're both throwing shade at Selena Gomez. So Kylie actually commented on a video where Devotedly Yours made this whole theory, posted it to her TikTok. And look at the response that we got. Kylie goes, this is reaching, no shade towards Selena ever. And I didn't see her eyebrow post. You guys are making something out of nothing. This is silly. Honestly, I love the fact that all of these girlies are commenting and responding. If they don't agree or if this wasn't the real reason as to why they posted it, then okay, like, put us in our place, put everyone in their place. I didn't make a video about it, let me just say, but put everyone in our place, including
Kylie Jenner is being canceled for, quote, making fun of Selena Gomez's eyebrows. This all started when Selena Gomez posted this story saying she wished that she was as pretty as Bella Hadid. After Selena posted that, Kylie Jenner posted this seemingly random story saying this was an accident, and then she posted this story with Hailey Bieber where they focus heavily on their eyebrows. Now, if you know anything about Selena Gomez and Hailey Bieber, you would know that Hailey Bieber does not like Selena Gomez at all. Well, this ended up heavily backfiring for Kylie because basically everyone took Selena Gomez's side. And because of this whole situation, Selena Gomez has now surpassed Kylie on Instagram.
Darkness inside of me, I've been following blindly. I am fighting for control, and nobody seems to know. I can't breathe, I'm suffocating. I can't see, I'm at my breaking point.
She deserved it, but I'm saying God's timing is always right.
I firstly just say this filter is like freaking me out. Like, this looks like in my face. This isn't my face. What the fuck? Okay, so we know all the Hailey Bieber, Selena drama that's going on, and I have a hot take, so no one requested this, but you're listening to it. In my life, like throughout modeling, I've encountered a lot of Hailey Bieber girls. Like pageants, modeling, like there's always Hailey Bieber girls. And they're usually very thin girls who may have a dance background. They usually come from quite wealthy families. They have hugely high expectations on themselves, which is why when they're so critical of others, they think it's normal because their internal dialogue literally hates themselves. Like, they will not even eat that muffin. They will not take a piece of birthday cake. Like, they like will brush their hair 300 times if that's what they're supposed to do, or they'll be like, they're so glued into every trend or anything that's going to make them look thinner, better. How to be better than everyone else is literally their number one goal. And all I'm getting from Hailey Bieber energy and all I've ever gotten is the exact same like girl that I've met in high school. I've met them in modeling, I've met them in pageants, and they are the nastiest people because I truly believe they hate themselves. Like they actually hate themselves and they know deep down that they don't have anything to offer the world other than their appearance. So that's why everything weighs so heavily on how they look and how they appear, because they don't have a good, they're not funny. Like they don't have enough energy to be funny. They don't have like, they can't cook or like, I don't know, make cool meals or like, they don't have any other talents. Like they literally can just look good. And even doing that is like killing themselves. And I feel like this is why they're so mean. Like they just are straight up mean girls. And there is no way this isn't directed towards Selena. She's obviously gained weight, which would be killing Hailey because like Selena obviously has health, like she has lupus, but she's clearly like a little bit more relaxed in how she looks. And she's probably eating pizza and she's eating cupcakes and like live your best life. She looks amazing. Like why not? And that would just kill Hailey. The fact that Selena is more popular, better liked, clearly a nicer person just from, we all see it. That would be eating Hailey up inside because the one thing she has is to be the prettiest queen bitch. That's my hot take.